Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Tom Reynolds, who is the Chief Executive of Scirocco Energy. Tom, great to have you on the line. And some news has just come out quite recently about your Ruvuma asset in Tanzania. What can you tell us?
Morning, Thomas. Yeah, that's right. So last week we put out a press release basically updating the market on some movement on the underlying asset. This is our Ruvuma asset that Scirocco has been involved with for a number of years. And as part of the company's transition plan from natural resource investment into transition energy asset investment, we agreed to sell that asset to ARA Petroleum Tanzania back in 2022. ARA and the other joint venture partners have continued to progress that asset, and that was the purpose of the announcement last week. The main thing is that I guess the two key points for me out of the release is that we continue to make progress on completing that divestment, which our shareholders will be very keen to follow. Although, given we were pushing up towards the end of Q1, which was our previous guidance for completion, we felt it was prudent to basically just highlight that completion is likely to slip into Q2 slightly later than we originally hoped, but we are making very good progress on all the various governmental approvals that has. It's probably worth saying, or just reminding perhaps for new joiners to the story, giving you an outline of what that deal involves. That was a sale for an asset sale of our interest in the Ruvuma asset in Tanzania for a consideration of up to $16 million, made up of a number of contingent payments. There's a $3 million payment that we would receive at completion, which is obviously what we're focused on right now. But then there's a number of contingent payments we would receive going forward linked to key events on the asset. And the second part of the release really covered how changes in the asset progress were quite positive for Scirocco.
Understood. Thank you, Tom. So how is the timeline looking for those contingent payments?
The underlying progress that the asset team have made is really very encouraging. Although followers of the asset will see that drilling of a key well has moved back due to rig availability, the operator has continued to progress first gas solutions, and they are now targeting first gas as early as October 2023, so this year. People who are familiar with the divestment that I just mentioned will be aware that Scirocco stands to receive a further contingent payment when the joint venture makes final investment decision to develop the asset. And then also we stand to receive a revenue share following first gas of up to $8 million as gas is produced from the asset. So the news that we announced last week is very positive because it represents a meaningful acceleration of when we had otherwise estimated we would receive those monies. If the asset and the operator approve development effectively through the course of this year, we stand to receive $3 million, and then we'll start to receive a revenue share as early as October 2023 with first gas.
So there's plenty for people to digest here, isn't there, Tom? But the bottom line is, what does it mean for shareholders and for your strategy going forward?
To really simplify this, Thomas, it basically means that we'll receive money from the sale of the Ruvuma asset much sooner than we had anticipated based on the guidance from the operator. And that means that we'll have more non-dilutive funding from that sale process to recycle into sustainable energy assets, which is the core of our strategy. So all of this represents more money to invest sooner, and that's just good news.
Looking to the future now, Tom, how is the opportunity pipeline coming along?
So obviously, whilst we've been waiting to complete the Ruvuma deal, we haven't been pursuing the opportunity pipeline as energetically as we might have, because we want to make sure we've actually got the capacity to follow through if we identify things. Followers of the story will know that we did invest in a company called Energy Acquisitions Group, focused on anaerobic digestion plants, and more recently, bolting on biofertilizer plants to those assets. The team there have made very solid progress and have identified a number of additional opportunities to invest. And that's the first place we will look to recycle the resources that we're talking about coming from Ruvuma sale.
And just one final question from me, Tom. You have also made some changes to the board recently. What do they mean?
Yeah, so one of the things that we consistently do as a board is continue to evaluate whether we've got the right skills, experience, and makeup based on the company at that time and looking forward. And the board has been relatively static since 2021, and we felt it was appropriate to look around. We actually got a candidate that was actually recommended by the company's largest shareholder, GP Jersey, in the form of Niall Roberts. And Niall's got very interesting experience in the fertilizer, biofertilizer markets in Europe, which has got a very strong link with the asset makeup that I just mentioned, taking AD plants, bolting on biofertilizer plants, and then having a fertilizer product to sell in that European market. So he actually brings very interesting new and experience to the board going forward here.
All understood. Well, you're obviously a very busy man, Tom, but thank you very much for your time this morning and best of luck for the year ahead.
All right. Thanks very much, Thomas.